So thank you, Kalyani Madam, for a very brief introduction. So
Thank you.
first of all, respected Chairman Sri M. Lakshman Reddy sir, Executive Director Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav sir, other management members, and chief guest of today's program, and also the resource person Dr. J. Ram Prabhakar, who is the Assistant Professor in EEE Department, School of Engineering, Amrita Biswa Vidyapeeth, Bengaluru. And convener of this program, Dr. N. Ramchandra, and program coordinators, Mr. Vishnu Vardhan and Ms. Isha, and all the advisory committee members, HODs, deans of various departments, organizing committee members, faculty members of EEE department, student volunteers, students of EEE department, last but not the least, the participant across the country. A very good afternoon to all of you. So I am Dr. Santosh Kumar Patro, principal of St. Martin Engineering College. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you all to this 2 days national level workshop, which is titled as Microgrid Integration and Transmission Towards Smart Grid Infrastructure, which is scheduled for 2 days, today and tomorrow. And already while the convener and the HOD Dr. Ramchandra, while addressing to all of you, he had already mentioned that this is the 8th event of the EEE department. I must congratulate to the HOD as well as the all the staff member, the dynamically they were working, and I have witnessed past 7 events were mega success, and I wish all the very best for this program too. And also I came to know that your department has scheduled one international conference in the month of July 9th and 10th. And I wish all the very best for that program too. That should be also a remarkable achievement to the glory of EEE department. So I sincerely appreciate the entire staff member of EEE department and the convener and HOD, Dr. Ramchandra, for taking all this extra effort and initiative and interest to bring out the best for the student. And and also I would like to extend my thankfulness and gratitude to Dr. J. Ram Prabhakar, even though in this during pandemic he is so busy, because they will have lot of other academic, and being a university, it is not that easy to take out the time. So he has agreed to our request and agreed to be with us and enlighten us what are all latest developments are happening in the grid. So thank you very much, sir, for accepting our invitations. And there are many couple of resources and resource person details also came to us, and while evaluating, we are very happy to inform at this forum that okay, so you are one of the best, and really the student and faculty will be benefited with your knowledge matrix what you are going to narrate for continuous 2 days. So thank you once again for accepting our invitation and giving your kind consent to be with us for continuously 2 days. And as the title suggests about grid, so I could able to remember some of the concept when in our childhood days we had heard. So grid means everybody knows. Then there was a concept called microgrid, and now we were talking about the concept called smart grid. So how it is has to be differentiated, grid, microgrid and smart grid, in the sense. So I always represent grid will be our traditional telephone, where you would have seen it will be a dialing tone where we have to rotate and dial. Then there was a era where we started talking about the mobile phone. So that I consider it as a microgrid. And now we all are using, and very well, everybody is well aware about the smartphone. So now we are talking about the smart grid. So grid, microgrid, and there is a smart grid. So this justifies this example, what level of technical differences are embedded with the system. And also, as we all know, microgrid is not a new concept. We know very well that it is an electrical system that includes multiple loads and distributed energy resources that can be operated in parallel with the broader utility grid or a smaller independent power system. And this is what we talk about, the meaning of microgrid. And how about the smart grid then? Smart grid is a concept of microgrid, but it is modernized electrical grid. which uses the information and communication technology to gather the information and act accordingly. And those informations are highly reliable for many type of advantages it gives, which improves the efficiency, reliability, and also it is very economy and sustainability of the production and distribution of electricity and cost saving. And it is one of the biggest advantages of smart grid is easy to troubleshoot. Any problem it comes, because it is all, once anywhere you make the presence of computer, it becomes smart. So once you made the computer, adopted computer in our any practices, that is become smart. And once computer is there, everything will be smooth and easy, because that is what the functionality of the computer should work for mankind, to make the people and user more comfortable. So the traditional way of going to each pole and grid and finalize and struggle very hard, find out where the fault is, that is all not required. With the smart grid, the system itself will tell you which power connection has gone down, where the fault had occurred, and it's very easy to troubleshoot, which is more important. So how quickly we restore the problem and get the electricity at our home, that is what the need of the hour. So I really appreciate the HOD and all the department faculty member for coining such a beautiful concept and deciding to enlighten all the participant with this information, so that everybody will be benefited out of this entire exercise. So I wish all the very best for your program. And also, I wish all the participants to have a very good learning. And please do take care of yourself and have a great day of learning. And thank you very much for the opportunity. Have a great day. Thank you.